So this is gonna be GP Master for all cups. Gonna be all cups, including the 64 disc drive expansion cups. This is really different from playing Shadow Man, that's for sure. I have to get into this. So the real challenge for this game is just not crashing. Because this game is extremely unforgiving in that respect. If you crash, you have to redo the whole track. And if you crash more than the lives you have for Master, I have 2 lives, you can see it on the top left of the screen. You have to redo the whole cup, and that would pretty much destroy this run. So in my estimate, I took into account that it may happen that I crash once or twice, but not that I would have to redo the whole cup, any one cup. This track is just trolling from the computer. You can actually lose some risky stuff, speed it up a couple seconds, but you know, with risk balance in mind, at this point I'm not gonna do it. Thank you. really a harsh change from Shadowman to this. Change of pace.
This trolling is so bad.
Right, next track I can either go complete YOLO or I have no idea. This is the first Risk track where everything is on the line. I didn't get the angle completely right on the last lap, and then it just would be suicide to go for that dive. This is another track where death is just around the corner. Thank you. That was the first cup. I decided that I would just reset after each cup because the victory scene takes forever. So it's RTA style. Now some more challenging tracks. This track can be tricky, depending on how much risk you want to take with the dives. So I didn't just go overboard with the risk, that would save a couple more seconds if you get more speed there. Chance of missing the track goes up a lot. Problem. Still using a really safe strat for this one. I may look into some more risky stuff in the future. sub-110 is definitely among the possibilities. That slide was really slow, so I lost some time here. But better be safe than sorry. Yeah, it may have looked quite good this run, but it was slow. Jack and Queen Cup is so nice to play. The risk is really manageable. But once I get to the next cup, that it completely changes. Every track is just completely crazy. Me a lot. I lost almost too much speed to make the final dive, resulting in death. Now the King Cup. I think this cup is probably the hardest cup of the whole run, or just the DD1 cup. Both of them are really difficult. Whoa.
No!
I knew it!
I knew it!
2 minutes?
Oh, I don't know.
At least more than a minute. So now this room is in trouble. Let's hope I get through the next few tracks well. I'm gonna play this track safe. There's a lot of risk to take. Actually, there's no way to really play it safe. The next three tracks are all three tracks where you can very easily get trolled.
At least I have one extra life still left. This track is mostly in the opener. At least I got through that part. Yeah, now it's pretty much okay. It's pretty much RNG dependent. Pretty good run. Alright. This track is completely crazy. At least I got through the opener. Probably the hardest part. One more lap. That's definitely a really safe strategy for that track. It's working now. It took me a very long time to find anything safe for that one. People that watch my stream usually will know that I have to hold back enormously for this track. But I made it, so that's pretty good. So only one crash, but it was in the last lap, so that really cost a lot of time. Joker Cup. Rainbow Road is the tricky track in Space Plant. Those are the ones. messed it up, but I'm still alive. Oh man. Awesome music on this track. Better be safe than sorry on that dive, especially in GP. You can win a lot of time, but you can lose much more. Right, good. Sub 140 is only if you get really good dives. Max is out at 135 if you get really perfect. Perfect dives. See how the computer just totally enabled to slide around the corner. No risk at all. Can do some fancy dives to save 3 seconds. Alright, this is definitely the hardest track left of the regular ones. Space plant. RNG, what's on that? You can get a really fast dive here, but for some reason I got the speed, but it didn't lift off. Alright, so this one I have to do with it. That costs like 10 seconds. But last week I also did a run on this. And then the computer just killed me right at the beginning of the race. So it can go a lot worse. Angle. 134. So if you get the opener dash, you get like 125, something like that. Last three tracks are pure slider stuff. Lot of tricky corners on all three of them. Some health management for safety. Gosh, what the fuck? All right. So you can see that when there are no dives involved, hardly any dives, and there's almost no risk. This contains one little shortcut. Can go really wrong if you get badly trolled. There. Perfect troll trap for a computer, this. So you can do some cool slides here to speed this up, this boring part. But it's not worth it in GP. Ha ha. gotta keep it tense, right? That's it for the normal tracks. My time is around 40, I think, something like that. What's this? Okay. So now DD1 cup. So it could have been easily sub 40 minutes if I hadn't crashed on Firefield. So DD1 is definitely. I think it's harder than the. Oh shit. I'm gonna quit now because this track is really fucked up with these settings. So, for some reason, it doesn't remember my settings. For any of the expansion kit tracks. So now I have to set all my settings. For the other tracks, I could just click through this. This is definitely the hardest cup, I think. It's harder than the King Cup. Mostly because the tracks are much more difficult to play. I got lucky there, so sometimes if you cut a little bit too much of that corner, the game just makes you crash. Oh fuck! I already hit the brakes and it still makes me crash. Oh shit. That's really stupid. I was already going really slow and it still made me crash. That didn't make. You have to go about 800 and then you're safe, but. Come on. So much time. See, the computer is also flying off because this track is unplayable. Mm-hmm. Soupy truck. It wastes like 5-6 minutes. Now this next track is not a hair better, it's maybe even worse. But these two tracks are definitely the worst tracks in the game. And this track I actually practiced a lot last week because I knew this track would definitely be trouble. Because this track is completely unplayable.
Fuck! It just gets completely trolled all over the place. And now I cannot restart the cup either. But this is gonna be it. All the rest of the tracks of the game I would consider normal, but these two tracks are just ridiculous and are unplayable. Still beating me. That bullshit is over. Just got major trolls. Now this track is sort of normal. I hope I'm still gonna make my estimate.
Alright, this next one is pretty fun to play, but it contains one very tricky dive in the end, with a very narrow stretch to land on. The safe way is to just crash in the wall like this. If you don't have enough speed, then that's pretty much the only way to do it. Okay, and no computer was ever to be seen. I didn't want to risk the dive to that narrow stretch, but in the end it was really rocky waters. This track layout is the map of Japan, meaning corners are extremely challenging. Thank you. trouble here, but there's a refiller. Pretty much time attack. Computer has no chance. Next cup, DD2. So it's really actually Silence 3, Major Troll Track, and Sand Ocean 3 that are really a pain to play. The rest of the DD1 cup is pretty okay. DD2 is also hard. One of my favorite tracks from Max Magic Kids. I'm the only one to finish the race. One of one. Yeah, this track's awesome. This track is quite cool, but it contains some really tricky parts. Especially one dive, the first dive where you can bounce when you land. Or get trolled pretty hard. How can they be so slow in these parts? It's just unbelievable. Opener was unbelievably slow because I got majorly trolled when I landed a dive. But okay, fine. This is about the only track in the game where you want to hit mines. to take shortcuts.
This has become a major part of the gameplay in the later game, later F-Zeros, like all the Game Boy games. Well, almost all the 2D F-Zeros have sort of a rival bumping or mind bumping stuff. Okay, really safe there with the mines, but yeah, I got it. Seems to be okay so far. This is definitely the trickiest track of the DD2 Cup. This track can pose a real challenge to my success of this run. Is it gonna work or not? It is gonna work, and it's gonna work perfectly. Excellent. That is really nice on the opener. Messed it up on the second lap. As long as I don't die, it's okay. As you can see, that's a 180 dive, and the camera is unable to keep track of it. If you time it perfectly, you can get over 2000 speeds when you land. If you time it wrongly, you miss a checkpoint and you die. And the 2000 and that is of course the most close together. So to play it safely, you don't want to be that close to the 2000. That part. Alright, this track is still a lot of fun to play, but it can be quite risky. That can happen, especially on the opener, that you hit that dirt stuff. I guess I'll just go like this. missed it again. That risk, I made it. It's a little bit too much risk, but it's faster, so don't think about it. Last track of the game, Bigfoot. Big hands, but worse. Good thing I still have 2 lives left, because this is major trolling, especially in the opener. Everybody's going nuts. I'm going to play it really safe now on the opener, and only on the boost laps I'm going to slide. It's not worth it. I'm already at the end now. Probably pass everyone very easily here, because they can slide for shit. Yeah, exactly, that's what I thought. Too scared to slide. Fuck! I was already gonna win it. This track is such a pain. Time.
Just barely under my estimate.
Alright, that's it. I just barely made my estimate. By 2 minutes.
That was bad.
Well, thanks for watching, everybody. I'll just log off now because we need to get going. Yeah, I play F-Zero X a lot on my own channel. WMJ Speedruns.